be able to fulfill your dreams and help others fulfill theirs. To have the courage to fight for what you believe in and achieve your most cherished goals against all odds. To serve your country with utmost devotion and create an enduring living legacy. To spearhead the revival of your cultural heritage and nurture an entire generation of extraordinary performing artists. To be held in the highest esteem by your peers and win honor and recognition from your country. This is the story of how a remarkable woman turned her love for her country and her passion for its dance and music into a glorious revival of its cultural heritage. The story of how she turned a childhood dream into a creative tour de force. A woman whose vigor and inspirational leadership transformed the cultural landscape of India. A story of struggle and success, of heartbreak and hope, of trials and ultimate triumph. Sumitra Charitram's life was blessed from the start. Born to a truly illustrious family on the auspicious night of Diwali in Meerut, fortunate to have enlightened parents, Raja Jwala Prasad, one of the founding members of BHU and the first Indian chief engineer of British India, and a doting brother, Dharamvira, one of the most distinguished ICS officers of free India, under the tutelage of some of the best teachers of music and literature, surrounded by some of the most remarkable people of that time, and exposed to the best of Indian culture from a very young age. The youngest of six siblings, Sumitra always got her way. Her childhood was filled with love, laughter, and joy. She woke up each morning to the soulful sound of the Shehnai, played by the legendary Bismillah Khan on the banks of the holy river Ganga. But for Sumitra, her greatest blessing was the extraordinary love she had shared with her husband, Dr. Charitram, for more than 60 years. When they met in 1932, it was love at first sight. Lalaji followed her to the Uday Shankar Center and would take photographs of her. She was a legendary beauty and his muse. Lalaji was an accomplished singer, and Sumitra would accompany him on the tabla when he sang. They were truly made for each other. Their long-cherished dream came true when they got married in 1941. They continued to enrich each other's lives till the very end, and Sumitra basked in the tender, loving care and generosity of her husband.
No words are adequate to describe the support and encouragement I have received from my husband, Dr. Charitram.
Sumitra was very proud of her illustrious family background and that of the family that she was married into. She gave her children an excellent childhood and was a very caring and concerned mother to her four children, Deepak, Shobha, Siddharth, and Gauri. Over the years, the bond kept growing stronger, and through all the trials and challenges of their life, Sumitra remained the ever gracious, devoted, and loyal wife. Growing up during India's freedom struggle, Sumitra was filled with patriotic fervor. Swept up by the feeling of national resurgence, she launched a second freedom struggle to liberate India's bonded culture. On August 15, 1947, as India breathed the first breath of freedom, Sumitra Charitram gathered a group of India's leading artists in exuberant celebration at the first Mehfil of Free India.
That night was very special. When I recall being a part of history being made, I feel shaken and fulfilled at the same time.
Never before had an evening of such dimension been organized in India. It was a dramatic moment that sowed the seed for what was to become one of India's most enduring cultural institutions. For Sumitra Charitram, it was the fulfillment of an impossible dream and the beginning of a lifelong journey of passion. The resounding success of the musical soiree encouraged her to form the Jhankar Music Circle, a coming together of a veritable who's who from the world of culture. The challenge of nurturing India's music and dance soon became an obsession for Sumitra. She herself joked that in addition to her own four children, she now had a fifth. She was already considered a mother figure by the new generation of artists, who called her Matri Rupen, mother figure. Indeed, Sumitra's home was home to all the greatest artists of India, musicians, dancers, choreographers, writers, poets. Sumitra opened her heart and home to everyone. She was always concerned that nothing should happen to the artists. Her spontaneous outpouring of affection and generosity of spirit were unequaled. The artists reciprocated with their deep respect and honor for Sumitra. When she fell ill in 1968, every single artist prayed deeply for her. She believed it was their prayers that led to her recovery. As part of her commitment to the arts, Sumitra expanded the role of the Jhankar Music Circle and transformed it into a teaching institute where budding artists could blossom and where senior artists could meet and interact with each other. In 1952, the Jhankar Music Circle was formally registered as the Bharatiya Kala Kendra. Its mission, to preserve the country's cultural heritage and promote performing arts. With the patronage of the Sriram family and under the guidance of Sumitra Charitram, the institution continued to honor its commitment. Even today, more than half a century later, it remains one of the premier cultural institutions of India and undoubtedly Sumitra's greatest gift to the culture-starved city of Delhi.
So it came to pass that over all these years, my fifth child blossomed and bloomed. The Kendra had become a home for arts and artists. I had not planned it at all, but by God's grace, it indeed became a center for the arts, a true Kala Kendra.
Today, most stars in the field of music, dance or choreography are either products of the Kendra or have had some professional links with it. Indeed, no other institution has so many Padma awardees associated with it. Over the years, Sumitra was to discover yet another blessing in the extraordinary creativity of her daughter, Shobha Deepak Singh, who introduced Mayur Bhanj Chhau to the Kendra. It has now become popular in India and abroad. With the support of her husband, Deepak Singh, she now runs the Sriram Bharatiya Kala Kendra. Rooted in the sky, with its branches spreading on earth, source and nurturer of all to whom it gave birth. Sumitra was completely broken when Dr. Charitram died in 2007 and lost her will to live. She herself passed away in 2011 to spend eternity with the love of our life. Sumitra Charatram, friend, guiding light, mother figure to 1,000 artists, connoisseur of India's classical arts, trustee of India's cultural heritage. Today, we salute the spirit of Sumitra Charatram, whom we are so proud to call our own.
My service to the arts and artists has been my reward. God has been extremely kind and generous, and He made me an instrument of His will. I stand fulfilled.